So think about the architecture and grandeur of somewhere like Rome. Throw in the cobblestone streets of Barcelona, put in some palm trees and beautiful beaches of the Caribbean, and then just for fun, sprinkle in the most amazing vintage car scene that you've ever seen in your life. And that, in a nutshell, is 3 days in one of the best places that I've ever been to in my life. Check this out. So about 20 of us from the remote year group went to Cuba over the weekend, and we spent 3 days exploring the beautiful city of Havana. It was honestly probably one of the best holidays that I've ever taken. The lights, the sounds, the smells, and of course the cars, like everything about this place is stunning and beautiful. Hold on, I think I found the Mexican version of the Backstreet Boys. Check this out. A lot of people describe the experience as being in a time warp, and there definitely is an element of that. But what really blew me away was the architecture of the place, the houses, the buildings, everything. Everything about the place is stunningly beautiful. It's just, couldn't stop taking pictures, couldn't stop taking videos. But you do see a distinct difference between the government-owned properties and people's houses. You see that the government has invested money into keeping and maintaining and preserving their buildings, but the houses decrepit and run down. The day that we got there, we went on this amazing classic car tour. For anyone that's thinking about going to this place, this is definitely a must-do. They're beautifully maintained, the colors are vibrant. I think I actually pissed off our tour guide quite a bit because I was just distracted by everything. It was beautiful. I couldn't take my eyes off the cars and the buildings, and I was kind of like jumping around like a little kid, taking photos and videos of everything. So there are two types of currency in this place. One is CUCs and CUPs. It's for the locals, and think of the other one as tourist currency. It's a one-to-one conversion between the US dollar. Basically, everything that you pay for minus some of the older taxis are all paid in CUCs or cooks. They're actually a lot more expensive than what you'd assume. We budgeted about $100 a day, and I think most of us blew through that by day two and a half of that three-day trip. What's also interesting is businesses and livelihood in the place. It was trippy that when you walk down the street, you don't actually see people doing anything. Like the concept of small businesses, so when you imagine walking down your local street, there's restaurants, there's fast food joints, there are shops that you can buy clothes. It's almost like none of these exist in this place. You can't stop in for a snack, and most of us were pretty famished between meals, and so hunger was a thing that we had to get used to. So you could get breakfast, lunch, dinner, but if we were hungry, if we were thirsty, it wasn't really a place for us to stop in and grab a snack. It was a really trippy experience. And even shopping for groceries was interesting. Like there's pasta, but no pasta sauce on the shelves. And then when you want to buy something like Kit Kats or chocolates, you have to actually go to a separate place inside the grocery store that's controlled by a security guard. You can't go and get it yourself. Sounds as though the infrastructure of the country is kind of still in the past, even though your surroundings may elicit you thinking that you're kind of in this beautiful modern city.
En el micro, escucha como dice Michael Nico. La música cubana vale mucho chico. Mi flow que estilo mira viene de La Habana. Baba, vas-y, bouge ton pied sur le beat, écoute ça.
Those that are traveling to Cuba, here's some advice from 3 days that we experienced. Start packing like you're going camping. So as I mentioned before, there's no way to really stop in and get snacks, so you're gonna get hungry all the time. So take some chips, take some energy bars, and whatever you need to sustain yourself throughout the day. Also take more cash than you need. Getting money is actually very, very difficult. So the ATM cards won't work. Need cash. The best thing to change is euros. Dollars actually gets docked a 10% fee when you convert it at the airport. So if you can, order some euros before you get there from your bank. Also try to go sooner rather than later, given the relations in the US are improving pretty quickly and the trade deals are all opening up. Get that real feel of old Havana and the old city while it still lasts. But for now, the sun's setting, time to get back to life in Mexico City, and I'll see you guys for the next episode. Catch you then. Entre blanc, le noir, le chico, la chica, Chicago à Panama, Tokyo à la Havana. Je représente la fiesta, le son des congas du mec en gras. Saca los collares que llego, Chango, Chango. Hey bro, él es guá, Chango, batalla, yemaya, Ochun, más fere, fumo, ruli, que mi canto.